Welcome to a video on the Law of Cosines. The goals of the video are to derive the Law of Cosines and also to solve triangles using the Law of Cosines. So just to review, a triangle that is not a right triangle is called an oblique triangle. And until now, we've only been able to solve right triangles. However, the Law of Cosines does allow us to solve certain oblique triangles. So the requirements for solving oblique triangles using the law of cosines is side angle side, where two sides and an included angle are known, or side side side, where all three sides are known. So here's the law of cosines for any triangle ABC, and remember that side A is opposite angle A, side B is opposite angle B, and side C is opposite angle C. So if we take a look at these three formulas, the most important part to remember is whatever angle we're using, the side opposite that angle would be the side on the other side of the equal sign. Let's go ahead and take a look at one way to prove this theorem. If we take any triangle and construct an altitude from, let's say, vertex B, we would have two right triangles, one here and one here. Next, if this entire length is b, we can let this length be x, therefore this length would be b minus x. Applying the Pythagorean theorem to this small right triangle, we would have c squared equals y squared plus the quantity b minus x squared. Now we can replace x squared plus y squared with a squared from the larger right triangle. Next, if we reference angle c, the cosine of angle C would be equal to x over a. Solving this for x, we can replace x with a cosine C. And then we have the law of cosines. And we can show the other forms by constructing altitudes from the other two vertices. Okay, let's take a look at a couple problems. Again, it's not important this is the scale, but what's important is we show the relationships properly. So we know angle B is 73.1 degrees, A is 24.2 feet, and C is 43.7 feet. So the first thing we should notice is that across from angle B is side B. So if we use angle B, the side B will be on the left side of the equal sign. So we'll be looking at this form of the law of cosines. Let's go ahead and set this up. B squared must equal A squared plus C squared minus 2. Times A times C times the cosine of B, which is 73.1 degrees. To save time, I've already found the value of this right side. B squared is approximately equal to 1,880.47. Again, I evaluated this on the calculator, but we don't have time to show it in this video. Now we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation. So we have B is approximately equal to 43.4. Let's go ahead and label that in the triangle. Now we have the lengths of all of the sides, and we have the measure of one of the angles. Now we can use the law of sines to determine one of the missing angles. Let's go ahead and set that up. Let's go ahead and use angle B. So the sine of 73.1 degrees divided by the opposite side, which is 43.4, feet must equal the sine of, let's go ahead and try to find the measure of angle A. Sine of angle A divided by 24.2 feet. Now we'll cross multiply. 43.4 sine A must equal 24.2 times sine 73.1 degrees. We'll divide both sides by 43.4. On the left side we'll have sine A, let's go ahead and bring it down here, is approximately equal to this quotient, which is approximately 0.5335. So now we can take the inverse sine of both sides, and A is going to be approximately equal to the inverse sine 0.5335. So angle A is approximately equal to 32.2 degrees. Let's go ahead and label that. So this angle is 32.2 degrees. We know the sum must be 180 degrees. So 180 minus 32.2 minus 73.1 will give us 74.7 degrees for angle C. So often after using the law of cosines, we will use the law of sines to finish solving the triangle. Let's take a look at one more. Here we have the length of three sides of the triangle. So side A is 25.4 centimeters, side B is 42.8 centimeters, and side C is 59.3 centimeters. So we have to decide which angle we want to find first, and it's recommended that we find the largest angle first to avoid any possible complications with the ambiguous case of the law of sines. So remember, the largest angle is opposite the largest side. So let's see if we can find the measure of angle C first. If we want to find angle C, we're going to have to use this form of the law of cosines. So we'll have C squared must equal A squared plus B squared minus 2 times A times B times cosine C. So notice it looks different than last time because the unknown is now on the right side. We need to go ahead and simplify all of this. I will show a little bit of work here, but you'd probably want to check it on your calculator. Combine like terms. Subtract 2,477 from both sides. Divide by negative 2,174 on both sides. So we'll have negative 0.3830 equals cosine C. Now if we take inverse cosine of both sides, we'll have C is approximately equal to inverse cosine of negative 0.3830. So angle C is approximately 112.5 degrees. Let's go ahead and label that. Now to find a second angle in this triangle, we'll use the law of sines. So we'll use angle C inside C to start, sine of 112.5 degrees divided by 59.3 must equal, let's go ahead and find the measure of angle B. So the sine of B divided by 42.8. Now we'll cross multiply, divide by 59.3. So sine B is approximately 0.6668. So if we take the inverse sine of both sides, so angle B is approximately 41.8 degrees. Now we can determine this last angle since we know the sum must be 180 degrees. So angle A measures approximately 25.7 degrees. Okay, that should do it for the law of cosines. There is another video that deals with applications involving law of cosines. Thank you for watching and have a good day.